bastard! Without this damn belt, we'd be dead.
My containment field's not working!
What? You sure? Check the panel.
I'm telling you, it's not working!
Fuck! Fuck, I gotta think. Think of something.
What are you doing?
You stand the best chance of destroying the Black Sun. Just take this and do
it. Those things are gonna slaughter you!
Take the damn belt and destroy the fucking condenser. Get out of here before I change my mind.
Inject you with a neural acid, which will put you in a permanent coma. Exactly what we did with your daughter.
It's too late. It's too late.
Nima Zafar, tu sais.
She's a slut and a witch.
What to do with witches?
We couldn't leave each other. Our souls were bound together. I loved you and hated you for years. You were a part of me.
Living, feeling, being in love.
I love you, Jody.
Growing old.
I love you.
So many things I still have to do.
Aiden?
We made it. Jody, we made it.
Aiden?
Ever since the Black Sun was destroyed, my memory has been disintegrating. I spent too much time on the other side. Now it's eating away at my mind, erasing what's left of it. My memories are all confused, slowly self-destructing, fading like a dream when you wake up. I'm losing my sense of time. I no longer know what happened before or after. Everything's playing inside my head at the same time. It's like watching the same film looping over and over again. A chaos of images with no order. So I've been writing night and day for weeks, trying to put my life down on paper. If I forget everything, these pages will be my memory.
3 months after the fact, the investigation continues in an effort to determine the cause of the accident that cost 283 lives on a Pentagon military base. Government representatives confirm that the authorities are working hand in hand with the investigators to shed light on this appalling tragedy.
The CIA is leaving me alone for the moment. I suppose they're too busy building another condenser to worry about me. I know they'll never abandon their experiments, now that they know what's on the other side. Honestly, I don't give a damn. Now I need to reconstruct my life. My life without Aiden. For as long as I can remember, I dreamt of living without him. Untied, without his constant presence by my side. I got what I wanted. I've never been so unhappy in my life. I feel like part of me has been amputated. Crying all day. I know it's stupid. Shit. I miss him so much. It took months. Months of nothing passing by. Then I woke up. I knew it was time. Time to start again. To build a new life. It was so obvious. Deep inside, I always knew. I just needed the silence around me. Hear what I was feeling. I told Ryan I couldn't see my future with him. We've been through too many difficult times together. Times I want to forget. He said he understood. That he'd wait as long as it takes. I know I felt something for him. Just wasn't strong enough. things at night. Terrifying things. I tell myself it's only nightmares, but I know it's not true. Once Pandora's box is open, it can never be closed again. No. It's not nightmares. It's what is about to happen. I've died twice already. I'm not afraid of death anymore.